we've got our referee in there. Aaron Wilson's going to be taking over the matches today and overseeing them, making sure that there's nothing untoward happening in that ring. How you doing, Aaron? All right, ladies and gentlemen, another edition of GCW Wrestling. We've got a great show lined up for you, including the return of Lonzo Lavizzi as he takes on Jake Long. And we've got a Super Bash rematch with Emma Graymas off against the Trinity's Hadley Flame. But in our main event, we're going to see the first qualifying match for the GCW Global Heavyweight Championship, a match that will take in 4 weeks' time at the Road to Wrestle Brawl. This will be a four-man ladder match. Now, let's get down to the ring for our first match. All right, from his Cecil resident in Paris, France, his opponent from Alice Springs, Australia, coming in here at 246 pounds. Jake Longley. Right, we've got both men in the ring. We're waiting for Aaron to go ahead and check them out, make sure that they didn't bring anything they weren't supposed to in there with them. And he's called for the bell. And here we go, folks. Our first match of the day. We still got time for you to go ahead, TP in your friends. Let them know to get on down here. Global Championship Wrestling. That's where they need to be right now. Two men circling each other. It looks like Lonzo's giving up a little bit in height and weight to this one. I don't know that it's actually going to be a factor. Or is that Jake that's giving up the height and weight? No. I guess Jake's giving up height and Lonzo's giving up weight.
But it evens out.
It's one of those days. It really is. We're going to start this one out with a little lockup and a nice big boot to the gut. Lonzo taking advantage early here. He's got Jake up under that armpit, squeezing his head. Aaron's right there on top of him, checking with him, making sure Jake doesn't go ahead and tap out on that one. Jake firing that one back with a big atomic drop. Lonzo laid out on the mat right now. Jake going down after him, but Lonzo's up and out of the way real quick. Jake's one of those that I don't know if he actually likes pain, but he can take a whole bunch of it before he goes down. Lonzo's going to win this by a pinfall. He's dead. It's doing some damage on Jake, and that right there might help him. Lonzo with that nice bulldog up stomp to follow up, and now he's picking Jake up. See what kind of gentleman Lonzo is. He's going to help his opponent up.
That's some good sportsmanship right there.
That was good sportsmanship. And then, woo, nice corkscrew. Going for the pin there, but no, he got a two count out of it. Woo, I thought Jake was going to run quick. That was a beautifully executed corkscrew. Once again, Lonzo is picking Jake back up. He's got him back on his knee right now. Sending him over into the corner. Nice big whip. Lonzo retreats to the other side. Looks like he's probably getting ready for a big old splash there. Lonzo charging into the corner. Gets caught by Jake's big boot. Jake, that leg just in time, catching Lonzo right on the chin. Lonzo down on the mat. Jake going to the outside. He's climbing up to that top ring, folks. He is on the top turnbuckle right now. Looks like he's waiting for Lonzo to get up, and here he goes. A huge flying close, taking Lonzo's head off. And now Jake's going for the quick pin. He's got one, two. Only a two. Wow, that was I'm surprised that Lonzo's head's still attached after that one.
He's not giving up that easily.
He must be quite resilient. He must be quite a resilient fighter.
Lonzo, not to be outdone, has gone and taken the aggressive shots again. Lonzo seems to be able to bounce back pretty easy from the punishment he took just a second ago from Jake, and Jake's a little wobbly getting up. Lonzo is standing there waiting for him, a big boot to the gut. And now he is going for a big strike. Nice.
I don't know.
And another one. And now he's back side headlock.
Alonzo in there taunting Jake might not be a very good idea.
Alonzo coming off the rope. A big risky maneuver, but he lands it. Big rebound crossbody right off the ropes there. Now he's going for that quick pin, and no, Jake's not going to have it yet. It's going to take a little bit more to keep that man down. Lonzo has definitely taken charge of this match. We very little offense out of Jake. Everything seems to have been Lonzo so far. Lonzo's on that top rope. Now he's going to the top turnbuckle. Jake trying to figure out where he is, crawling over to the corner.
Lonzo saying he's calling it, and the ref telling him to get down off the ropes. Oh! Well, that, I don't think, was the idea he had.
Probably not. That whole landing on the Tinder bits was probably less than ideal for him.
Was an awesome superplex there, though. That's for sure.
Jake going for an exhausted pin, right? I don't know how much gas Jake has left in his tank. Alonzo's not quite out of it yet, though. Wow, that was nice. Jake doing that. Knock down like that, and Jake coming up with that big superplex, taking him out of that corner.
Jake looking exhausted there, but he's not giving up. But Lonzo's still standing strong somehow. Oh, and what a kick to the gut that was. And now he's just, that one's going to hurt in the morning. And he's going off the ropes, and he is going for... And he gets a big boot to the face. And there goes Jake again, trying to pin. There goes Lonzo, sorry. Getting confused.
Both men are down. Ref starting to count.
Doesn't look like either of them are getting up from that. Oh.
Jake's starting to move there.
Yep, Jake's moved.
Both men are. Oh. Ref up to a five.
Getting close.
Lonzo coming up first.
Lonzo saying he is getting ready to finish this one. He is going out again. He's going to try this one again. Hopefully he can get it off before Jake knocks him back down. Lonzo up there. He's being told to get out of the corner. Ref is warning him. Lonzo's up. Is poised there. He is waiting for Jake. He's waiting for the perfect opportunity, and there he goes.
Jake rolled out of that just in time.
That was a gorgeous blue arrow, but nobody was home. Jake was awesome. He is waiting for him, and now he has got Lonzo. Now he's got him, and one of those, he's not even going for the pin. He is going for the submission. The boomerang stretch, one of Jake's signature moves. The boomerang stretch, he is putting all that pressure on Lonzo's back.
And Lonzo has tapped out. Jake has won by submission. Speaking of submission, Shade seems to submit and isn't around. I wonder why that is. Taking a break, or more like he's scared to fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of your first match by way of submission, Jake Longley. Somewhere. Yes, Hadley. Always good to see you too. How you doing? All right, and Riley's going to start off talking. Well, last week I beat Nixie after she brutally attacked me with a chair, and that makes me once again the rightful champion. However, she was disqualified, not beaten. Candace is coming right back with, she thought she could beat you, and now look, she's our little slave. And Riley's saying that yes, and in a couple of weeks her slavery will start. And Candace wants to know what Riley's plans are for Nixie. And evidently she has a few plans that may or may not include me. I have no idea. All right, and Hadley is up there saying, but that's not why we're out here. Tonight, I want some revenge against a little punk kid backstage, Emma Greymist. Get your ass out here. From Kansas City, weighing in at 160 pounds, representing the Trinity, the Scorching Seraphim, Hadley Flame.
Shouldn't she be on the streets? You're not getting the attention of every man she can.
All right, so we have a rematch from the Super Bash. Emma and Hadley, and if you remember, that was Emma's debut into GCW, and she actually lost that one to Hadley. So we're hoping for a bit different turnout this time, or at least I am. But hey,
you've got room to talk, Riley. Yeah, make it look like she did it. You're not even the champion, you just think you are. You suck. Just remember that. Oh, I'm right. Doing my job.
As we hear a little shouting match going on between Emma and Riley, Aaron has checked both women over. Emma giving away a good amount of size and weight here, almost 50 pounds in the weight department. It looks like she's giving away damn near a foot in height as she's coming into this one. So let's hope she'll be able to overcome those obstacles. And right there, Hadley's showing off her power, sending Emma straight down to the mat. Emma Emma, not one to be intimidated, though, coming back up right at her and hits her with a couple of big slaps. Emma's telling Hadley, don't underestimate her. And right now, Emma's giving as good as she gets, right in there, standing toe-to-toe with Hadley. Well, it's more like face-to-breast with Hadley, but you know what I mean. She's right up in her, I can't even say it right. She's trying to be right up in her face. And, Emma showing a little bit of her power, sneaking around behind Hadley, getting her in that nice big waist and taking her down with a belly-to-back suplex. That was a beautiful move from the smaller girl, Emma.
That was an... Oh, and an elbow drop. You should never underestimate the people that are smaller, because sometimes they're stronger. And they do say the bigger they are, the harder they fall. So, that's always a factor.
All right, and we had our first attempt at a pin right there.
And Emma, she only got a one.
Aaron was right there on top of it. Emma is showing Hadley that it's not size that matters, because we got a little firecracker there. Hadley standing up. Emma back.
Pushing her back. Oh, and a kick to the gut. Hadley showing off her power there. And she's just throwing Emma against the ropes there. Emma coming back and getting speared down to the ground. Good attack from that.
Emma on the offensive.
Cocky with her attitude. She might need to rethink that. We'll soon find out.
Riley sitting over here encouraging Hadley, her teammate. I wonder if this could be a setup so that we're going to end up seeing a tag team match with Nixie and Emma going against Riley and Hadley. I'd like to see that. That'd be
interesting. Yeah, I would. I'd enjoy watching Nixie and Emma kick Hadley and Riley's ass. Yeah, they may think that they're better with their sly moves, but Nixie can own them.
Emma standing back up with her own shove, backing Hadley up a little bit. Nice kick to the gut, and then she's following up with a couple of big slaps right into the bigger lady's face. And now Hadley pushing Emma up against the ropes. Right now, Hadley's not showing much except that she's a big girl. And that was a beautiful belly-to-belly suplex. Emma coming
I think big is an understatement, Wade. She kind of takes up, like, most of the ring.
And now Hadley going on up to the top rope. She is turning around and looking. She has Emma laid out on that mat. Hadley waiting. She's poised up there. And there she is. High flying maneuver. High risk maneuver. A big splash. She lands it. That was a lot of woman coming down on top of little Emma. And now she's going for the pin. Hadley's got the pin. One, two. We got a two count. Emma gets her shoulder up. That was almost it for Emma. That was almost it. But the girl's got a little bit of
that she wasn't going to give up. Emma may be Hadley small, right, but she handled the body weight of Hadley on top of her and still managed to pull out of the pin. May have been last minute, but at least she managed to do it.
Hadley right up in Aaron's face. She doesn't like the call. She thinks that was a three. I still don't understand this. It's not like the referee's going to change.
It definitely was not a three. And she's currently arguing with the referee. And so Emma kicks her in the face, knocking Hadley down. What a maneuver. Such power from Emma there. And Emma has Hadley in some sort of headlock over there. And she gets out of it and throws her against the ropes. Ah, shut your face, Riley. Nobody likes you. Maybe you can go and join Shade. Maybe you can go and join Shade and be a chicken, just like he is. Can't even fight his own battles.
And back in the ring, we had Hadley performing a beautiful enziguri to leave Emma laid out on the mat once again. And we see Hadley is going right for those ropes again. She's climbing up.
Yep, she is. And she's going for another move. And straight the body weight on down on top of Emma again. Yeah, maybe she's not running out like Shade. But she's just as bad as him. He's a dirty players, man. He's as bad as Shade. Shade only chickened out of Super Bash because he can't fight. He's not even worth it. Thinking that he can wrestle and he can't even get in that ring and stay in there. A week off, yeah, okay. He knows nothing.
Back in the ring, we have Hadley doing that flying star press, and she has not let up since she landed that. Emma in a lot of trouble right now. Hadley with those big boots stomping on the younger lady, the smaller girl. Hadley trying to punish Emma for coming into the ring with her to show her that she doesn't belong. Emma's going to have to figure something out. And that was just a pure insult. There was no reason for that slap other than to humiliate Emma. Now with that big boot and Hadley getting ready, Luke, finish it. Goes.
And Riley's just moved in. She's standing outside of the ring. I wonder what she's going to do. Are you going to jump in and help your friend, is it?
And we've got the pin going on after that powerbomb. One, two. Oh, Emma stopped the count this time. Hadley stopped the count this time, pulling Emma's shoulder up. Hadley did not want to win yet. I believe she has a little bit more in store for Emma. I think a little bit more punishment is coming. It may end up costing her in the end. Emma's looking a little out of breath in there now. Power for power, she can't go up against Hadley. Emma's going to have to figure out a new technique, a new way to go at this. There's no chance that she's going to go power for power against Hadley.
Sometimes Hadley, that little bit that she's doing there backfires, too.
Riley yelling for Hadley.
Emma is hurting on the ground. Hadley standing over her.
Looks like we had a big Poffo cutter there.
You've got room to talk, Hadley. You know, it's your body weight that makes you bigger and stronger. And what was that? Emma just turned that around.
A beautiful super kick from Emma. catching Hadley off guard. Now Hadley laying out flat. Emma needs to get her wits back about her, need to catch her breath. She needs to form some kind of offense, some kind of attack that is going to keep Hadley down. There's no way she can stand toe-to-toe with her. Emma's going to have to use her speed and her agility. She's going to have to keep Hadley off balance and off her feet if she's got any chance of pulling this one out. Riley over there facing off against Honey Blunt and not happy with somebody in the crowd.
Is that all you can do, Riley? Fight with a crowd? You can't even stand up for yourself, never mind fight battles properly.
And now we're going for an exhausted pin, and we got it. 1, 2, 3. Emma pulls it.
Emma has.
It's the pin. And your winner, ladies and gentlemen, of the second match. A replay of our Super Bout from Belfast, Northern Ireland. Emma Graybist.
Do you know what it is? He was back there in the back. He seen the honey was here. Knows she has some good shit on her. So he was hunting for her stash.
Hey, you wanna go ahead and introduce Bruno?
Yeah. And coming in now from Stoke, England, weighing 200 pounds, Bruno Fernandes!
And this is Bruno comes into the ring shouting, "Worship me, I am the man of GCW."
Honey, be careful offering up searches. They may decide to do strip searches. You might get more than wild. Benja, I do not.
Now, why are you telling lies, Lori? You love it. Just admit it, it's fine.
See my halo? It's nice.
Yeah,
and
your horns are the things. Your horns are the things holding it up.
Here we go. There goes the bell.
All right, Aaron seeming to be satisfied that neither one of the men brought any contraband into the ring with them. And now they're getting ready to face off. The bell is rung. And there we go.
Ah, there we go. The men are going round and round in circles. What is this, a carousel? Or a fight? Just saying.
They're just sizing one another up.
Oh, well, we all know what Wilde's into. And a punch of the face from Wilde knocking Bruno down and being helpful and helping his opponent up. And kicking him in the gut. Wilde is showing off his power. And he... whatever that was. And Bruno punches him. punches him again. And he's going off the ropes. To kick him in the face. Wilder's now down on the ground. And Wilde getting up, but he's angry. Oh, Wilde looks angry. And they're in a lockup. Showing off their power against each other. And Wilde punches Bruno in the face. Bruno punches him back. And Wilde punches him again. And Bruno, it is a continual cycle. And he choke slams him, by the looks of it. And he's punching him while he's down on the ground. Did nobody ever tell you, Wilde, do not beat a man when he's down? Dirty fighting. And Bruno is holding his head. He seems to be injured over there and still down on the ground. Bruno, get up. And he trips up Wilde. Brilliant. Brilliant.
Well, considering they're both contenders coming up for this Road to Wrestle Brawl, they're going to be doing anything and everything they can to beat one another to
and get that. Bruno tried to pin, but only got a one because Wilde jumped out of it just in time. Well, not just in time, he only got one count. And Bruno's still down on the ground. Oh, but he's getting up. And he's not a happy bunny. And he throws Wilde against the ropes. And he knocks him down again. And Bruno is now standing over Wilde as he is on the ground and now is picking him up again. And he's throwing him against the ropes again. Over the ring. I don't think that was meant to happen. And Bruno knocks him down again. Bruno is fighting his corner here today. Not giving up easily. And Bruno is going off the corner and literally that one's gonna hurt. And he puts him in a pin. 1, 2 and Wilde kicks out at the last minute. Bruno not giving up.
Just
Wilde
two.
Not ready. Not ready. To give up this match. This is a very, very important match, and neither of them are going to give up easily.
No, but you can see that frustration building in Bruno there.
Yep, it's angering him. It's very much angering him. And Wilde then and knocks Bruno down to the ground. Bruno is now holding his head in pain yet again. And Wilde is trying to pin him. 1. Almost 2, and that was all he wrote. It is not over yet. Bruno is still on the ground. Get up. You can get up. You'll be fine. And Wilde assisting him up and putting him in a hold. And kicking him to the gut. Pushing him back.
Oh, and an Irish.
And then he does more damage to Bruno's head.
Aaron and getting on him for that eye rake.
And stamping on him. And he's going for a pin again. And it's a one. And it's a two. And Bruno kicks out again. Bruno is not giving up. He's getting angry over here, but he's not giving up.
Bruno's going to need to do something to come up, because he's been...
Oh, and he's wobbling as he gets up off the ground. And Wilde is having an argument with the referee, and Bruno has got up behind him. And... Oh, what a move. And because he was too busy arguing with the referee, Bruno took advantage of that and knocked him down. And Bruno elbow drops Wilde. And what is next? Wilde is still down on the ground.
The elbow took a little bit out of him.
Yep, definitely. And he's stamping on him. Doing some more damage.
Well, you can see the frustration there using those ground stomps to take it out on him.
Yep. And he's helping him up, even though he's just had him on the ground. What is Bruno doing? And Bruno flips him over and knocks him back down to the ground again. And he is now dragging Wilde away from the ropes.
Bruno going in for that pin.
That was good awareness on Bruno's part to get Wilde away from the rope so that he couldn't break that pin with a leg or an arm out there reaching.
And now Bruno has just done whatever that was to Wilde. Even though Wilde just got out of the pin, Bruno still managed to pull something round him. So what's he going to do now? Wilde is looking awfully exasperated over there. And now he's wobbling around the ring. And Bruno punches him in the face. And goes off the ropes. Or not. Oh, yep, off the ropes. And knocks him Wilde down yet again. He's down on the ground, Bruno. You need to keep him there. This is an important match. And Bruno is getting up on the ropes. What is he doing? And elbow drops Wilde.
Bruno coming off the top rope with a huge flying elbow drop, landing that right on Wilde. Wilde taking the brunt of that one. All of Bruno's weight and the impact. There was no place for his head to go, no place for his back to go. And that one landed hard. We got a two count out of that as Bruno went for that pin right there. Wilde in a lot of trouble. Bruno taking advantage of the fact that he's been able to switch this one around now. Wilde had better come up with something too. These two men are going to have to keep going at it. Bruno's going to have to keep Wilde off his feet. Wilde's going to have to find a way to use his size and strength to his advantage, or else it's all over for him.
And Wilde has just got up. This battle feels like it's never going to end. And,
ooh,
what an eye rake. And punches him in the face. Bruno not giving up easy. Oh, and he kicks him in the gut. And Bruno throwing Wilde against the ropes. And Wilde coming back off the ropes. knocking Bruno down with that kick. That one is going to hurt in the morning. Bruno holding the back of his head there. And... oh! And a powerbomb by Wild Thing to Bruno, knocking him back down on the ground again and attempting another pin. One, two, and Bruno kicks out again. Bruno is not giving up yet. He has lost a lot of energy, but he's not giving in. Wild getting angry up there.
Just 5 minutes left in the time limit for this match. One of these two men has to make a move, has to go for the pin and make it stick, or else they will get disqualified by the time. So they need to get this one going. They need to figure it out. Wild needs to either get that strength going and his size, or Bruno's going to have to come up with something to get Wild to stay down.
Exactly. Because we are running really low on time here, so they need to hurry up and finish this match before it becomes a disqualification.
Both of these guys are just meticulously tearing each other apart bit by bit.
It seems to look that way, Laurie. It seems to look that way. But Bruno and Wild aren't exactly on the best of terms. And Bruno trying to pull Wild into a submission move. Bruno pulling his arm back there.
Got him in that crossface. Holding him there. Trying to get him to tap out.
It's not going so well.
Aaron is right down in there. The referee is right down in there seeing if he's going to tap. Bruno exerting the pressure on that shoulder. He's bending that arm back. Wild using as much power as he can to keep it from happening. This is one that
Wild is not giving up.
Wild refuses to tap out. Bruno is straining. He's trying to keep Wild from breaking that hold. Wild may take some damage to that arm, but he is refusing to let go. He is not going to be tapped out on this.
Bruno coming in there cocky to begin with, and he's still holding his own, even against Wild in this match.
As long as he's held that hold, I don't know how much damage Wild is taking to that arm. He's going to have to get it up, or they're going to have to break it. I don't know what's going on here. The ref should have already been either getting him out of this lock or taking the tap out. This is insane. Even if he does get out of this, that arm is useless for the rest of this match. There's no way he's going to be able to do anything with it.
Exactly. But the need to hurry up and break this hold. They're running low on time yet again. They need to get up and finish this match. Otherwise, it is going to be... And Bruno gets him out of that hold and gives him an elbow to the chest.
And that was it. Bruno couldn't get him to tap.
Bitch. Wild trying to get up there. Wild wondering about the ring there. And they're in a lockup. This is not the right time to be in lockups. And a kick to the gut by Wild to Bruno.
Another eye rake from Wild.
And a kick to the gut. And another powerbomb.
A huge powerbomb. A giant powerbomb from Wild. Wild lifting Bruno up like he weighed nothing, pulling him all the way up to his 7 feet height and slamming him down to the mat.
And,
one,
and the winner
two,
of this match by pinfall is wild. Saint. Thing. Yeah, that. Yeah, got confused. Bruno did not give up easy that match, though.